ever notice how most dogs don't understand the concept full? Huh? They just keep eating until they finish whatever it is you put in front of them. That's because the average canine in dog years is about the same age as a middle-aged man, or as we call them, the buffet years. The question is, wouldn't it be great if you could put out a whole week's worth of dog food without having to refill the bowl every day? The answer's obvious. Get yourself an old car with a retractable sunroof. You can pick these up pretty cheap from a middle-aged bald guy with a sunburn where his hair used to be. All you need is the roof. The rest you can sell as a convertible. Maybe to the bald guy's wife. She's probably looking to trade up. Just dish out a week's worth of dog food into that giant salad bowl you got as a wedding present and then never used. Once Rover's done with it, you never will. You slide the dish under the sunroof so the dog can't get at the food unless the unit is open. And sure, yeah, I could open the sunroof manually, but I got a better idea. I've hooked up the on-off mechanism to this solar-powered calculator. Oh, sure, the solar panel's pretty small in this unit, but that's okay, because once I place her in this windowsill, she's only going to catch the sun from, say, 10 o'clock to roughly 10:02. That you never thought you'd say. Things like, I'll have the vegetarian lasagna. Or, it was my fault. Or, not tonight. Well, here's another one. Harold's having girl problems. Yeah. Yeah. Well, Harold's got this girlfriend, Bonnie. And you know, Harold, he always goes overboard with everything. And if he goes overboard with Bonnie, I just want to make sure he's wearing a life jacket.
Beautiful day.
Uh-huh. You and Bonnie have been necking, Harold?
I do not kiss and tell.
Your face does. Yeah. You two should leave your glasses on when you're smooching. You could lose an eye.
Bonnie kisses way better than any other woman.
How many women have you kissed?
My mom. Yeah.
See, that's what bothers me, Harold. You don't have enough experience with women.
It bothers me, too, believe me.
Well, see, it's because you're focused too much on Bonnie. You know, you should be dating other girls.
That sounds crazy to me.
You should be dating other girls? You never heard that before?
Yeah, but only from other girls I've asked out.
No, no, see, Harold, if you spend too much time too soon with Bonnie, well, something could happen. You know what I'm talking about?
Every time I'm with her, I do get a big hint.
Okay, okay, all right. See, that means you agree with me. You guys should just kind of cool it for a little while, eh? Now, you want to tell her or you want me to tell her?
Oh, no, 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 not you, not you. No, I'll tell her, I'll tell her, I can tell. I'll just simply say, Bonnie.
I'll tell her.
No, I'll tell her, I can tell her, I can tell her. It's not that big, I can tell.
All right.
What am I telling her? Oh.
Is this coupon for a romantic dinner for two at the drive-thru window of the Burger Barrel. You'll enjoy a four-course meal. Burgers, fries, onion rings, and Pepto-Bismol. All right, Dalton, cover your ears. Red, you've got 30 seconds to get Dalton to say this word. Boxers. Boxers.
Yeah, all right, Winston.
And go.
Okay, Dalton, you got a ring and you got two people fighting like crazy.
Marriage.
No. These are pros, okay? And they have gloves and they have mouth guards and people pay to watch them punch each other out.
Hockey players.
No, okay. Okay, you got two guys doing this, eh? What are they? Two guys going like this.
Maraca players?
Okay, almost out of time here.
Yeah. Okay. Dalton, some men wear briefs, other men wear...
Well, how would I know? Wait, how do you know?
Come on, Dalton, you know this one. This is like baggy underwear. You know, not the tidy whiteys you and I wear. I mean, these are shorts.
What? You mean trunks? Only boxers wear trunks.
There we go.
This fall, a bold new reality program comes to television. 12 lucky women will enter a fairy tale. A chance to live in the lap of luxury with the man of their dreams. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to embrace the good life. This fall, 12 women will compete to win the ultimate bachelor. Handsome, connected, heir to a multi-million dollar fortune. Or is he? Winston Rothschild is Joe Musty Air.
Because reality sucks.
You know, every man has a mountain of some kind to face in his life. If he's a single guy, the mountain is probably laundry. But with the single load capacity of these machines, this is an all-day job. And all day and job are two things I never like to see in the same sentence. What we need is a washer dryer that's large enough to handle all the laundry at once, assuming we don't care about mixing our whites in with our colors. And that's a pretty safe assumption. That's why today I'm gonna build a multi-load washer dryer. My laundry is like cargo, but I'm gonna use a car that doesn't go. Actually, I recommend a hatchback. Hey, look, it's the hatchback of Notre Dame. Okay, first thing you want to do is remove all the seats from the vehicle using whatever tool you have handy. I guess that's me. You want to get an even distribution of water throughout the wash cycle, so cover the interior of the car with as many of these lawn sprinklers as you can find. My neighbors all water their lawns at night, so getting these sprinklers is pretty easy. That's not funny, Harold. Now, this vehicle has a sunroof, so she makes an excellent top-loading model. Just jam all your clothes in here. Don't worry about overloading the machine. You know, I once saw 15 clowns get out of a vehicle this size. Sadly, 16 had gotten in. But they dedicated the world record to them. Why do clown stories always involve death? Okay, sock the laundry detergent in there. Hey, these things really do let the sunlight in. Remember the Fab Four? Well, this is what the Fab's for. Oh, tide's coming in. In fact, I'll just... All right, Harold, all right. Okay, we got our sprinklers running there, and I hooked the hatchback up to the Possum van with a tow bar. And I stuck a concrete block behind the rear wheel. That'll allow me to do a little agitating. I've always been good at that. If my man is rocking, I'm probably bleaching my underwear. Okay, now we have to drain the washer before it turned into a dryer. That's where the hatchback comes in handy. Done. This floor mat is my sheet of fabric softener. Okay, now for the drying, I really need to generate some hot air. So I turn the heater on full, and then I drain the rag. You just start her up. And it's just that easy. So remember, if the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. Now, if you'll excuse me, it's time for the spin cycle. Only. The other day, I'm driving down the highway there, and I see a guy nearly miss his exit. So he cuts across five lanes of traffic to make it to the other side. I thought I was going to end up on the other side, too. The final other side. The one with the pearly gates and my old dog, Porky. Who got crushed by a runaway wheel of cheese. This guy couldn't take the next exit and come back because an extra 4 minutes out of his day was apparently worth more than the rest of my life. Then yesterday, I'm in the express checkout lane at the supermarket, and the old guy in front of me with 97 items realizes he's forgotten to buy a watermelon. So he disappears back into the store while I stand there thinking about what he can do with that watermelon when he gets back. The common theme here is that some of us seem to have forgotten an important concept. And it can be summed up with two words. Too late. Don't ever be afraid to tell yourself, it's too late to do something. Too late is your friend. Because you never know when your selfishness might tick off the wrong person. Someone with anger management issues and a firearm. Then it could be you in front of those pearly gates playing fetch with Porky. Oh, sure, by that point, you're sorry. But guess what? Too late. Remember, I'm pulling for you. We're all in this together.
You need a sewage guy you can grow old with. Because remember, your sense of smell is the last thing to go.
Rothschild Sewage and Septic Sucking Services.
Okay, it's been 4 hours since Harold went over to tell Bonnie that they're seeing too much of each other. By this point, they're probably seeing all of each other. Boy, there's a scary visual.
Come right in.
Come right in. Because I do things like that for you. I don't mind.
You two might want to cut back on the sugar intake.
Hello, Mr. Green.
Yeah, hello, Bonnie.
Harold and I had a little talk.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
And Harold said that you have something you wanted to tell me.
Let's say I want to buy a car, and the only dealership in the area is a Yugo dealership. That means I'm going to end up with a Yugo, right?
I love Yugos.
Me too, I love Yugos.
No. That's not the point.
That's not the point, though.
No.
You got to make an informed decision, which means you got to look at all your options.
I love Yugos.
Bonnie, I think my uncle's trying to help us avoid making a mistake. You know, he's saying that maybe we should just stop seeing each other for a little while. Just a little while, see how it works out, see if we really care about each other.
That's it, exactly.
Well, if you say so, Harold.
I mean, we could try it, and we could stop seeing each other for, say, like...
An hour?
A day?
A month?
A week.
A week, all right.
Because we don't want to get together just out of convenience.
I guess not.
No, because that's what my Aunt Bernice did, and...
The boys were out on a summer's day looking for a different beach. And they were just cruising along, and Bill was feeding Harold, keeping him happy in the back seat there. And they saw a sign that they had never seen before. Of course, they didn't realize the sign had a little more to it than that. So now we're operating under what we call false pretenses, which pretty well describes their entire lives. So Walter and Bill just can't get out of the car fast enough to scramble up and see what's going on at the nude beach. Now, Harold has a little more common sense and, you know, fair play and that kind of thing. He's saying, hey, guys, hey, you know?
What?
You gotta be one to see one, you know what I'm saying? So now they gotta make the decision. Are they gonna, or not, okay, they're gonna go for it, all right. Decided to pay the price. Harold has a great idea here, because we got some toys and so on they can use to cover up some of the embarrassing bits, and the rubber ducky, and even using the cooler there, and there was one of those pop-out things, and so Walter grabs the cooler, and if he takes the bottom out of her, it'll be just like shorts, really, and Bill's got the rubber ducky in it there, and, which I believe he got on prescription. And, of course, Harold then is left with the tent, which is one of these spring jobs, which should... I think it's going to be large enough to cover everything Harold's embarrassed about. So now, next thing you know, over the hill come the three musketeers. And about now, they realize, hey, wait a minute, this isn't the nude beach at all. Those are families. There's one kid playing catch, and he kind of takes offense to the way they're not dressed, so he fires, firing rocks at a boy. Oh, boy. Oh, there was another one. So Harold decides to hightail it out of there. Of course, by this time, the car has been illegally parked for a while and has attracted a cop. And once she sees the way they're not dressed, the ticket takes on a whole new level. This is not just going to be a fine. This one's going to involve taking a little trip downtown, because it's going to have to be appearing in court. It says right on there, see, summons to appear in court. So Bill doesn't take this as seriously as he should have. He just kind of uses it as his bathing suit. And once she got a glimpse of that, she changed it to read, small claims. Free, that is. But now I decided to turn the run on from a liability into an asset. Something my wife does with me on a daily basis. See, when I shut the car off, it runs for exactly 23 seconds. I figure that should be just about perfect. Okay, I got my tent all rolled up, mounted on the roof of the car. When I pull this rope, that tent will drop faster than the Canadian dollar during a Quebec election. First, I have to shut the car off, which means she'll run for exactly 23 seconds, which is just about the right amount of time to inflate my tent. Or as I call it, my inflatable garage. Okay, we're into the fourth day of Bonnie withdrawal. It's going okay. I mean, it's a one day at a time thing, but it's going okay. It's not easy, believe me.
Okay, okay, right, come on, we gotta go. You said you're gonna take me to the botanical gardens, right, so we can see the forsythia in bloom. Then we have to go down to the electronics store because I want to get a new MP3 player, right?
It's not easy, believe me.
And of course, we have to go to the library, and we have to hurry because that closes at 8:00.
We're not going to the library, Harold. That's all the way up in Port Asbestos.
We'll go to the library in Possum Lake.
We have a library? Where's that?
Right next to the liquor store.
No kidding.
Oh, Harold, what's wrong?
I'm not supposed to see you, Bonnie.
What's going on? It's only 4 days.
I got a message from Pookie. He said it was an emergency. Oh. I thought you were sick. Your voice sounded all scratchy. No.
Well, I don't know what that's all about, but since you're here anyway, you two might as well get back together.
I gotta go to the meeting.
No, Harold. You go with Bonnie.
Really?
Oh, yes, Harold.
Where do you go?
We're going to the botanical garden.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, if my wife is watching, I'll be coming straight home after the meeting, and I hope I'll find you in an affectionate mood.
Because it's an emergency.
For the rest of you, thanks for watching. Got myself and Pookie and the whole gang up here at Possum Lodge. Keep your stick on the ice.
Sit down. All right.
Quando, Omni, Flunkus, Moritati.
Sit down. Bow your heads in a man's prayer. I'm a man that I can change if I have to, I guess. All right, Harold's not at the meeting tonight because I think he's in love. So let's have 2 minutes silence.